students, today we are in the second session of our lesson Diversity in Living Organisms. Yesterday we talked about diversity. What does the term diversity mean? Now we will see why should we study this diversity. Yesterday we saw diversity. I showed you a flower, two flowers, one of rose and one of hibiscus. The two were belonging to two different groups. So today we are going to study about the diversity in animals. So when I say animals, I brought, they are dead, but two insects I have brought here. This is a honeybee, dead one, and this is a beetle insect. So when we observe these two insects, are they similar? No, they are different. That means diversity not only in plants, there is diversity in animals too. But they all belong to one group. This beetle belongs to insect. This honeybee also belongs to insect. They both belong to one group. But still, there are differences. Maybe in the segments, maybe in the legs, number of legs. So here we have so many differences even in the group, inside the group. So that means significance of diversity. When I say we have this diversity, if we know this diversity, say we can be able to study, appreciate, you know, appreciate, like you appreciate the role of flowers. These flowers produce nectar. This nectar attracts the insect, helping cross pollination. So there goes the cycle. So that is, we are appreciating the role of flower in asexual reproduction. Sorry, sexual reproduction. So now it helps to study, appreciate and group the different living organisms. So that means we can group different living organisms. Now if they have, we just saw animals, they belong to different groups like insects. So these insects all belong to one group. So here they help us to group, study, appreciate and group different living organisms, and they are all due to this diversity. Diversity, when I say, they are based on the variations. Variations, now what is variation? Variation means the presence of differences. Variation is presence of differences between organisms of same species. Like yesterday we saw hibiscus flower and rose flower. These two flowers, they belong to different groups. Though they may have some similarity, there is more number of variations. So these variations, when we go from group to group, one species to another species, the variation increase. So this, what are these variations? Very important term, presence of differences between organisms of same species is called as variations. Now, what is the significance of this variation? Because of this variation, what happens? This variation between different species is greater than variation within species. Different species means, now if you take, yesterday we took neem and mace. These are two different species belonging to two different groups. So here differences are many. Like the variation is different, here the arrangement of leaf is different. So many, n number of differences are there between these two species. But if I take a tall neem and a smaller neem, they belong to one species. Here the variations number is less, because both leaf have reticulate venation, arrangement of leaf is same. So what does this mean? Variation between different species is greater. Variation between different species means for a maize and neem, their variation differences are more than variation within species. You can see the structure of their body. All this, if they have together, you club them together into one group. Like you have bats, you have crow. Different they are having, though they belong to same group, that is birds. Still, there are some differences. There are some variations in them. Because both of them use their wings to fly. But the structure of their wings are different. So here, variation form the basis of selection of characters to group organism. So if you have now, we are going to slowly go towards the grouping of characters based on the variations. Now in your class, when you compare your friends, though there are some similarities, like you have two eyes, your friend also has two eyes. You have one nose, your friend also has one nose. So though there are some similarities, still you are different from your friend. Maybe your hair color is different, your eye color is different. So these are all the variation. Height. Follow? So this height, body, structure, personality, these differs. So in your class, there is difference between two students. Same way, in plants, in animals also there are differences. So, did you all understand this concept of variations, which forms the basis for grouping? So, remaining we will do in the next class. Stay safe. Thank you.